Hey guys, it's Lisa and welcome back to my channel. I'm so excited for today's video because as you guys can see from the title, I'm going to be doing my very first luxury handbag review and I'm also going to be going through my very first experience buying a luxury handbag. So before we dive into the video, I just want to say I am by no means an expert in luxury handbags because I haven't collected that many myself. However, I have used both of these bags for about 2 years now, so I feel like I can give a really good proper review from a frequent user, if you will. So if you are deciding between one of these two, then definitely stick around. And even if you aren't debating between these two bags specifically, I am also going to be going through some of the thought processes and some of the things that I considered when I was buying my very first bag. And before I get started, I just want to say that not both of these bags are mine because they are ultimately design-wise still quite similar. So that's why if you are spending money on this bag, if you don't have that much disposable income to buy two very similar looking bags, I definitely would just get one or the other. But in my case, one of them is actually my mom's and the other one is actually mine. So that's why I have two very similar looking bags. Anyway, I wanted to start off with my experience of buying my very first luxury handbag because I feel like once I explain my thought processes and some of the things that I considered, you'll kind of understand why I decided to choose what I chose. And then I will officially go into my review and you guys can see if, you know, I have any regrets or if I made any mistakes, etc. So I will definitely be going through that. But if you are here just for the review, I will leave a timestamp here for you and you guys can jump right to the review as you guys wish. So the first thing that I considered when buying my bag was what the purpose of the bag was supposed to be. And what I mean by purpose is why you're getting the bag, how you're gonna use the bag, and how often are you planning to use the bag. And the reason why I considered purpose first is because I realized that once I got that out of the way, it helped me determine all of the other things that I needed answers to as well. Later on, I will kind of touch upon, you know, price, color, and versatility. But once I determined the purpose, it really helped me answer all of the other questions as well. So personally for purpose, the reason why I wanted to get a luxury handbag was because at the time, I got this about 2 years ago and I was using my Marc Jacobs bag for almost like 4 years at that point. I got this really cute Marc Jacobs shoulder bag and I carried it around everywhere. And I loved it because I would have all the essentials in there. I would be able to put my phone, my keys, my wallet, lip balm, gum, etc. And I find that it was the easiest because even if I was going to work, I was able to just, you know, put on my Marc Jacobs shoulder bag and then carry my laptop bag. And then once I got home, if I was going to meet up with my friends, I would then just ditch my work bag and just continue to keep my Marc Jacobs bag. So it was pretty much the bag that already held everything I need. Every other occasion that I need it, whether it was work or whatever else, a day trip, I would always carry the Marc Jacobs bag and then I'll tack on something else. Like I said, I got this 2 years ago and the reason why I had started considering was because during this time I started to take Instagram a little bit more seriously and I started blogging and YouTubing more, so I was taking more pictures and I find that I was still using the high school bag that I got and used for so many years and I thought that it was time to elevate my style. At this point I had also been working for about 1 or 2 years, so I thought that, you know, this was a good time to get an introductory bag, but I wanted it to replace the Marc Jacobs bag. After I determined that purpose, I realized it helped me decide all of the other things that was gonna come later. The second thing that I considered was price point. And like I said, after I had determined the purpose, figuring out the price point was really easy for me. And once again, your price point and my price point might be very different depending on the purpose of your bag. For me, like I said, I was trying to replace my Marc Jacobs bag. And because I was also a new graduate, I feel like I wanted to start off with something not too expensive because I almost couldn't justify just graduating and then spending $6,000 on a Chanel or something like that. For me, I was like, I needed something not as high key. And then also because I wanted to use it every single day. So I just feel like some of the other bags, if I were to use that every single day, it might seem very extra. Like, I don't know, like, would you use a Birkin every day? Not really. Some of the occasions that I thought of myself using the bag is like, you know, like I said, sometimes carrying it to work, sometimes carrying it to a bar, sometimes carrying it to night out with the girls, especially going to work or some more casual occasions. Gucci and the bag that I had my eye on was kind of like the perfect price point for those, rather than if I were to go to a bar, I probably wouldn't want to bring my Chanel unless if it was like a wallet on chain. Anyway, I'm totally going off topic here, but that's basically how I arrived to my price point. I think that your price point would be different if you were really looking to collect or if you really wanted an expensive bag and using it only on special occasions or something like that. I think your answer could be very different, but that was kind of how I got to my own conclusion on price point. I also wanted to mention that price point, I also meant price point slash brand, because I feel like once you kind of determine the range of your price point, you are able to quickly figure out which brand would be most suitable for that. Because for example, for me, since I had an idea of how much I wanted to fit into a bag and sort of a good idea of what my price point would be, I knew that if I wanted to fit what I wanted to fit in for Chanel, that would be quite expensive. And it kind of helps you figure out after the price point, sort of relatively which brands would be a good fit for that. So the next thing that I considered was color. And this one was a very easy choice for me because, like I said, once I figured out that I was trying to replace my Marc Jacobs shoulder bag, I knew that since my Marc Jacobs was black and it went with pretty much everything and it was easy to clean, I wanted to get another black bag as well. So that part was pretty easy. And once again, I feel like it's different if you're someone who is trying to collect a bunch of handbags. But for me, because it was such a once in a blue moon situation, I definitely had to stick with more versatile colors. So for me, it was black in this case. So the next thing I had to consider was the style of bag. So pretty much at this point, I had already narrowed down to two of these bags, which is the Gucci camera bag and versus the Gucci flap. And this is where you have to decide which style of bag you want, because in so many cases, a lot of these different brands, they will have the same type of size bag, but in completely different styles. And honestly, it does make a big difference. And it once again goes back to your purpose. And personally, this is where I had the biggest trouble deciding. At this point, I'm probably gonna just actually go in and review the two bags. But basically, when I purchased the bag, I was on a trip to San Francisco with my parents. I wasn't actually expecting to purchase the bag on this trip at all, but because I don't see my parents very often, I see them about once a year or twice a year, I was on this trip to San Francisco with them, and on our way back, there was a duty-free shop and there was a Gucci inside. So my parents actually kindly offered to purchase it for me as my very first luxury handbag. While we were in the shop, I was still having so much trouble deciding between which of these Gucci bags to go for. And after 45 minutes of literally being so indecisive, I finally decided on this one. Like I said, I wanted it to be very versatile, and the Gucci Marmont flat bag, you can actually wear this in three different ways. So you can wear it obviously like as a shoulder bag, so just like right across your body. You can also wear it just off to the side like that and just like let it hang straight. Or the last option is you can actually go ahead and put the chain up and wear it like this. So for this reason, I ended up going with this bag, also because I wanted to go with the velvet versus the leather, because since I wanted to take pictures with it, I felt like the velvet was nicer since it was more camera friendly. Like, it made it look pitch black rather than the leather. It looks a little bit lighter, if you guys can see what I mean. So like, this velvet makes the black look a lot darker than the leather. That was another reason why I chose the velvet. And then the other thing that made me choose the velvet was because after looking at so many pictures of buying the Gucci Marmont flap bag, I realized that everyone who had the leather one would have such a deep crease on their flap bag, like right here. It would be completely flat and it would have such a sharp crease up here. So I realized that with the velvet bag, it doesn't do that as much, and it was also a little bit cheaper, which is why I ended up going with this one. Another thing that I wanted to mention dimension that you need to consider is choosing the size. And I know that you should have already kind of have an idea of what the size is based on finding out how much and what you want to fit it in. But in reality, I feel like the sizes, when you just hear it on the website or see what the sizes are, it's really hard to just go, yeah, I'll have the mini versus the small versus the medium versus the large. You actually need to show up and bring the things that you want to fit in it and try it on, and also wear it against your body to see what it would look like. And when I say it's actually important to try it on by bringing your things and seeing it against your body, is because between this bag and this bag, it almost looks identical in terms of size, but this one is actually the mini and this one is the small. And on top of that, the small for the flat bag was so much bigger and looked huge on my body compared to the mini. So even though in my head I thought that I wanted the small, it wasn't until I was there in person until I realized that the mini for the flap suited me, but the small suited me in the camera bag. So there actually is a difference, and I feel like, you know, a little does go a long way. Like, even though visually both of these look kind of the same, I actually needed to try it on before realizing that this fits slightly under the small for the camera bag. So anyway, after I decided on the Gucci Marmont flat bag in velvet in the mini, I finally told the person at the register and we rang it in. But right after we made the transaction, my mom was like, I'm actually gonna get the camera bag. So I was like, oh my god, we literally spent like 45 minutes debating when she was gonna get the other bag anyway. So I was like, okay, whatever, totally your choice. And it's funny because it actually just went home to Vancouver with my mom, and this one came home with me in Ontario. So how I ended up with both was because every time I go back to Vancouver, I would just use my mom's bag and I would never bring my own. But I ended up actually liking this bag a little bit more. So my mom was like, you know what, just take it, and the next time you're back, you can bring back the flat bag, which is what I'm gonna do when I see them next, which is actually coming up. She's not actually without a bag, guys. She's getting her bag back, just a different one. But basically, after using it for 2 years, I can basically tell you that the short answer is I like the camera bag more. And now I'm gonna go into a more in-depth review. The first reason why I actually prefer the camera bag more is in terms of price. So at the time of purchase, this bag, which is, once again, I just want to clarify, this is the Gucci Marmont velvet in size mini, and this is the Gucci Marmont camera bag in size small in leather. So in terms of price, this one is a lot more worth it, just because, number one, the material itself, leather, is theoretically more expensive than the velvet. So when I was looking at this bag in the exact same size, but the only thing that was different was velvet versus leather, the leather was a lot more expensive. This one I purchased at the time $2,100 Canadian without tax. This one was priced at $1,300 before tax, and this is in the small. So even from a size perspective, this one is more worth it since you can fit more in it rather than this one here, because this one is the small and this one is the mini. And I know, even though visually it looks the same, earlier as I told you, when I do try to fit everything in there, this one ends up fitting more. For those two reasons already, it is so much more worth it in price in terms of the material and also in terms of the size. I'm sure there are reasons why this one is more expensive anyway, like all the hardware on this one compared to the other bag. Just from a price point perspective, like, you would think that it would be a little bit closer, but it was actually a much bigger difference than I personally thought it was. But once again, I'm not an expert, so maybe this was fair pricing, but in my novice opinion, I just felt like, wow, this is so much more worth it in that regard. The next reason why I ended up liking the camera bag more is just because of the versatility. So once again, based on everything that I had gone through in terms of my own personal checklist, I personally made a mistake, because according to my checklist, I should have just gone for the camera bag because I wanted to use it every day, and this was gonna be a lot more versatile than the flap bag, because this flap bag, first of all, is a little bit more glamorous, I think, than what I personally was looking for. And also, the biggest reason is the two holes on the side of this bag makes my stuff fall out all the time. I actually lost a pair of Mejuri earrings because one time I just didn't have time to put on hoops. So I was gonna put it on in the car, and because I was just wearing the bag on my shoulder, and when I sat down, I guess maybe the earrings had fallen out either in the parking lot or something. I just could not find the earrings afterwards. They were my Mejuri hoop earrings, and I was so sad that I had lost it. But it wasn't even the only thing that I had lost. I had lost so many more things because of this little hole right here that if you had lip gloss or lipsticks and stuff, if you weren't careful with it, like if you were sitting down in a car with the bag on, you just have to be very careful to hold the bag up to make sure that things are not just falling out left and right, like your lipstick, your chapstick, I don't know, just any of these little things, or if your key is not like very chunky, it might also fall out. So for that reason, I kind of regretted getting this bag for the purpose that I had in mind. So in the last year when I had both bags, what I started doing was I started to just wear this as my everyday bag that I had intended it to be, basically like my Marc Jacobs replacement. And then I would just use the flat bag for more special occasions or when I'm out taking pictures. But this one became the one that I ended up using for what I had intended to use it for, basically. The last thing that I wanted to say, this will be different if you chose the Gucci Marmont flat bag in leather, but in terms of the material, if you're also considering velvet, and I'm actually not sure if they even make velvet anymore because I was on the website trying to look at the prices and I didn't see the velvet on their website. So I'm not sure if it's just because from a site perspective they don't sell it anymore, or if it's actually like a entire brand thing. If you are looking to determine between velvet and leather, definitely the velvet is, don't get me wrong, I do like it for aesthetics, and I felt like once again it was really good for the crease here, that it creases a lot less. However, it is a little bit harder to take care of because if you were to drop anything or like if any liquids were to go on it, I feel like it would obviously absorb a lot faster, whereas the leather, you can automatically like dab it off, or like the liquid particles would just still be floating around, whereas this one would absorb quite quickly. And the other thing also is I'm always having to lint roll this bag. It does collect all of the little white lints everywhere, so I do have to clean and lint roll this bag more frequently than this one, which is never. So that's another reason why I do tend to like the camera bag more. So all in all, my final conclusion really is I prefer the camera bag more. But once again, that's because it matched my purpose of the bag a lot more. If you are also thinking about using the bag every day, I definitely would go for the camera bag 100% because it keeps all your belongings safe inside and you have the zipper. Whereas this one, the chances of you losing something small is very high. If your purpose of getting the bag is to get something more statement-y and something more just for special occasions and stuff, for that reason, I would actually choose the flap bag. The other thing I do want to mention as well is that the camera bag, you can obviously only wear it over your shoulder across or just kind of like letting it hang here, whereas this one provides the other option of letting it hang off to the side. So that was another thing that got me in the beginning. I was like, I can wear it in three ways instead of just two, but I just don't think it was worth the stuff of me losing things and just like having anxiety if I lose things. If your purpose was more similar to mine, then definitely get the camera bag. If you have other reasons and want a more statement bag, I do think the gold hardware on the flat bag looks better personally. But yeah, that's pretty much my conclusion. I also do want to mention the one thing I do not like about the camera bag though, I feel like the zipper is quite rough, and I'm not sure if it's because my mom before me used it quite often, but when I started borrowing her bag, I noticed right away that the zipper was quite stubborn. So I might actually go into the Gucci store and see if there's something they can do. I just feel like it needs some sort of like lubricant or something, but obviously because of the price point of the bag, I'm not gonna be doing it myself, because anything you do to a designer bag, I think voids the warranty. So just be careful, and they do have great customer service. So I am just gonna go into the store and see if they can do anything for me. But if not, then that would be a con for sure because of the zipper, because it is quite stubborn and it's not as smooth as it can be, in my opinion. So that's like the one con of this bag that I wanted to mention as well. Anyway, that was pretty much the video for today. I hope I did all right for my very first luxury handbag review. Please leave a comment below and let me know if I was missing anything in terms of reviews, if people typically include other information. I would love to know and make my next review even better. I would love to keep doing this as long as I keep getting luxury handbags. So let me know if there's anything I can improve on, but I hope you enjoyed this video. And if you are also buying your first luxury handbag, I hope my tips were helpful to you. And if not, if there's any other questions, please leave a comment down below and I can answer it there. But just wanted to say thank you so much for your support and watching this video, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.